So stand up nice and tall. Perfect, yes. Okay. All right, feet together. All four corners of your feet press down into the earth. All right, we're going to ground down. Take an inhale in, sweep your arms up, deep breath in. Slowly exhale and lower the hands down to your count of eight. Let's go three more times. Inhale. Keep your gaze soft. Breathe in through the nose and out through the nose. You need to connect with your body. Starting at the soles of your feet, plugging down. Begin to notice how you are feeling standing up inside your body today. Relax the shoulders. Walk over to your chair. Go ahead and sit down. Let's find a comfortable seat so that we can begin to more deeply center into our practice today. And find your blocks and rest the soles of your feet down, letting your knees be a little higher than your hips. Keeping the circulation flowing through the lower body. Sit nice and tall. Allow your eyes to close. And allow your hands to rest comfortably on the top of your legs. Bringing your focus to all the parts of your body that are in contact with support with the bottom of the chair, with the blocks underneath your feet. Into the pit of grandiosity where our confidence makes us think that we are greater than, or the opposite, where our esteem is lower because we feel like somebody else's confidence is higher. It's good to be aware of those two ends of the confidence comes from within. Whereas cockiness or low self-esteem comes from outside, from competitiveness, from comparing yourself to other people. Confidence is a magnet. It draws people to you. Competitiveness, cockiness, low self-esteem pushes people away, pushes things away. So let's take a moment here to sit with this idea of what confidence means for you and how maybe you can weave that into the intention for your practice today. Chin down to your chest, go open the back of your neck, sit up tall, draw the shoulders away, and inhale, lift the chin up high, arch the upper back, open the front of the neck, allow the eyes to open. Inhale, bring the body halfway up. Breathe into the chest. Exhale, fold all the way down. And inhale, press all the way up. We're going to warm up the prana. We're going to warm up the fire in our bellies a little bit here by doing this about three more times. Exhale, all the way down. Inhale, rise up halfway, nice, long, strong back. Exhale, lower. Inhale, sweep the arms, rise all the way up, nice, long, strong back. Reach up, look up. Exhale, empty the belly, pour yourself forward. Inhale, halfway up. Inhale, sweep up. flip the palms. And then bring them all the way up and through. This is always fun. All right, so you've got the hands through. See if you can touch, squeeze the elbows towards each other and bring your shoulders back. And now squeeze the elbows in towards your chest. Lift the chest up. Beautiful. Slowly, let's exhale and bring the wrists gently around and forward. And we're not gonna let go. We're gonna do this a few times. Gently roll the wrists in and up. And exhale, forward and through. Last round. Nice. Beautiful, bring them out. Let's release the hands out, shake them out. Let's lower the shoulders down, relax the shoulders. We're going to take the left hand forward. Right hand, clasp your hand, your fingers, so thumb and first finger, right around the space between the bones of your wrist and your hand. There's a little tiny gap. Squeeze thumb and finger together. Squeeze the entire area, and then open and close your hands. Feel a nice compression there. Just releasing some of the tension in the fingers. And as I exhale, release the hand, shake it out. Feels nice. All right, other side. Sweep the arms up. Look up, lift the chin, see the hands, fingers clasping, press the palms straight up, arch the upper spine like you're doing a first morning stretch. And then let's exhale, bring palms and the hands forward, sitting up nice and tall, bring the shoulders back into their sockets. Nice. All right, now push the tops of your fingers forward, so we're opening up and stretching front of the fingers. Nice. And let's exhale. Bring the palms together. Lock the elbows straight if you can, if it feels good. Extend the fingers straight. And now we are bringing right over left. So we have the tops of the hands are touching. And then we bring the palms downward. And now we're going to clasp the fingers. Perfect. And then sweep them up. Sending the knuckles up towards the sky and the elbows towards each other. Bring the shoulders back down into the sockets and squeeze the elbows in. Okay. Deep breath in, elbows down, fingers away. And then we're gonna do a few dynamic breathers. Slowly bring the hands back forward. And then inhale, bring them back in, rolling out the wrists gently. Inhale, as your hands come towards you. Exhale, sending that stale prana out and away as your fingers go away. Nice. Let's go ahead, extend them out. And release, shake them out. Okay, now on the wrist. All right, I'm gonna see if I can demonstrate this way so that you can see what I'm doing. You're gonna have your hand turned towards you, but I'm gonna turn mine towards you all so you can see. The fingers come up along the top of the bone here between your wrist bones and the heel of your hand. And then you take your fingers and you squeeze them into that little gap, squeeze tighter. And then begin to open and close your palms. You feel that? I'm gonna demonstrate here, because I think you can get it in here. So it's this little gap right in here. You feel where your thumb starts to move all by itself? I want you to really get in there. So it's a compression all the way around. Squeeze them out. Oh, feeling the muscles, right? You start feeling your muscles get fatigued, and that's me trying to sneak in a little bit of the workout into the yoga. All right, one more circle. Beautiful. Now we're gonna hold those elbows up because we're feeling a little bit of fatigue here. Hold them up, extend the arms out. Okay, we're gonna hold them here in our nice little warrior two for maybe a minute. We're gonna try a minute or 10 seconds in. Now, to distract you, I'm going to have you turn your palms up. All right, now just lift them up a half inch. Open the chest, send your thumbs back. Yes. Deep breath in. A lot of fatigue comes from not breathing. Our muscles need oxygen. So breathe in deep. Give the muscles the oxygen they need. You're using your muscles all day long, but you're breathing enough to keep them oxygenated so they don't complain. So if you just breathe a little bit more, you can find that homeostasis once again. It's why runners can run for miles and miles and miles, because they figured out a way to breathe enough to feed their muscles during that process. You think they're feeling fatigued that whole time, they're not. You know, they've actually figured it out. It's okay, lower them down. Don't let your ego get in the way either. Okay, that was a minute. Nice job, everybody. Now let's lower them down. Nice work. All right, let your hands hang. Don't stop breathing. If you are breathing in a little bit of a faster motion, continue oxygenating. Continue breathing. Beautiful. All right, let's walk the hand over to the right side. Place it on the outside of your right hand. Bring the other hand underneath. Just kind of scoop it underneath there. And then gently lift it up and stretch the shoulder. Yeah, it's gonna feel good. So keep that
busy days that do that.
Yeah.
Okay. Deep breath in, sweep arms up. Fill the chest. Look up and reach up. Exhale, turn the body over to the right. Left arm on the outside of your knee or the outside of the chair, and then right hand on the back of the chair. Lift up through your chest and turn your upper body back. Nice. As you breathe in, you sit up tall and think about the bones right behind your heart, the bones in your spine, about turning those towards the side of the room. And then maybe bringing your neck and your upper spine into the twist by sending the chin towards the back. Beautiful. Last breath here. Excellent. Let's go ahead and release the back of the chair. Bring everything forward. Let's extend the legs out. You've got the heels pressed down and the toes shining up. Nice. Let's begin to point and flex the toes. You're pointing your toes and then flexing your toes. Yes, beautiful. So you're just gonna nice point and a nice flex. Point and flex. Point, send the foot away. Flex, touch the heel down. Point. I'm doing it through the mouth to make sound, but I'd like to see you guys doing it through your nose. One more time. Nice. Let's go ahead and release it out. Exhale, take a little break. Come forward. Let's relax the spine. Curve it all the way down. I'm gonna hold here for a few breaths, just letting the breath return back to its natural rhythm. Touch the knee towards the elbow.
step your feet away from the chair a little bit so that there's some room between your body and the chair. Okay? Now, take a look at your arms. Are they, you've got them extended out the past. So the wrists of your hands are away from your shoulders. Step back a little bit more so that now you're reaching towards the back of the chair. And then drop your head down in between your shoulders as you push your hips towards the knee. Coming into a modified downward facing dog. Feeling that opening up in the back of the legs, in your spine. Breathe here. Gently play with a cat-cow shape in your back. So arch your back. And then tuck your hips, tuck your chin. Keeping the arms extended out nice and long. Explore into the length here. Explore into the places where you can find a nice, comfortable stretch. Beautiful. We're going to do two more rounds here of cat-cow. And maybe you want to invite your chin into the cat-cow. Maybe you want to tuck the chin in when you tuck the hips. And maybe you want to arch the back and lift the chin up. Remembering to breathe smooth and deep. Nice. Take your last round here. And then find a neutral spine. Make sure you've got your hands plugged into your chair, palms really gripping. And then walk the feet in a little bit so that you're now stacked, shoulders above wrists. Okay, so now you're standing in a table shape, facing your chair. Good, good, good. Take your right hand and place it right in the middle of the back seat of the chair, so right underneath your heart. Nice. Yeah, so you've got your right hand right underneath your heart. And we're gonna inhale, lift the left arm up, bend the right knee. Beautiful. You are doing great. I love it. Turn on. hand, then you're going to move the knee back to center. You're going to send the knee straight down and keep the leg up. Reach your hand back towards your ankle. What other people are going to do this? Beautiful. All right, we're getting there. And really turn your hamstrings on. So either way, we're all having a wonderful practice. Let's exhale, I'm going to release the foot down and come over to the other side. Left hand on the side of the chair. Weight of the body into the sole of the left foot and lift up onto the toes of your right foot. All right, plug your belly button into your spine. Right there, we're turning everything on in here. You can even pull all the muscles in your pelvic floor up, and that helps to hold the knee up. Deep breath in. Yeah. Oh, hand at heart center. And see where you're comfortable lifting your knee up to. Beautiful. If you haven't found your drishti point in front of you, find a focal point, a drishti point to look at. And open the knee out. Exhale, bring the knee back to center. Send the knee straight down. Keep the heel bent. Send the heel towards the glutes. So send your heel towards your bum. And then if you want to reach down towards your foot, your ankle. And you can reach towards your foot and grab your foot or continue to squeeze your heel into your bum. Either way, it's a wonderful practice. Lovely. And let's exhale. Lower it down. Good work, everybody. I want to get everyone nice little hamstring stretch. Let's come over to the other side of your chair. Come back over here and stand facing the side of your chair. I'm gonna try this out. I'm not sure if it's gonna work, but I feel like it might. We're gonna take the foot that is on the outside. So for me, that's my right foot. For you, it's your left. And place your knee on the back of the chair. Let's see what it does. Okay, beautiful. All right, now reach towards the heel of your foot and grab it. And give it a good squeeze in. Nice. Excellent.
Oh, that feels good.
Let's have a water.
lock the knee and let the back of the knee open up. Good. And then go ahead and bend the knee, place your ankle right on top of your right knee. Yeah, see how close you can get the ankle to the knee. Beautiful. And if you have to hold it there with the belt, that's okay too, as long as you're not feeling any pinching or any intense pain. And take the left hand, press it onto the top of your knee. Push your knee away from your body and breathe in. Good. And let's go ahead and exhale nice and tall. Send your chest forward through the front of your shirt. What we're searching for here is a nice opening up of the outside of your hip. Nothing intense. Just a nice opening up. And breathe in here. Most importantly, exhale. We have a lot of stress hormones that we hold in this part of our body. When you exhale, you're helping to detoxify. Send all that stress away. Last breath here. Placing your hands on your shin, on your knee, press your upper body up. Sit up nice and tall. Extend the leg out. Let's transition gently and intentionally out of this shape. Release the belt. Flex the right foot. And loop it underneath. We're still sitting up nice and tall here. Extend the heel out. So you're trying to push a wall away from you with your heel as you send your toes towards your forehead. Opening up the back of your knee. So lock the knee if it feels good and feel that nice opening up in the back part of your knee. One more strong flex through the heel. And then exhale. Place the ankle on top of the knee. Nice little number four here. And the closer you can get your heel towards your knee, let's transition out of this shape. Slow and controlled. Inhale, send the foot out. Exhale, gently lower it down. Let's release foot. And you're going to end the class the way you started with one seated sun salutation. Hands at your sides, sit up nice and tall. Soles of the feet plugged into your block. Deep breath in, sweep the arms up. Nice and slow to your count of eight, fold forward. Inhale, halfway up. true self-confidence.